Everyone present to rise and recite with me the Pledge of Allegiance to our flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. In the absence of clergy, may we all bow our heads in a moment of silence. The reading of the journal. Secretary will read.
In Senate Sunday, March 7, the Senate met pursuant to adjournment. The journal of Saturday, March 6, was read and approved on motion. Senate adjourned.
Without objection, the journal stands approved as read. Presentation of petitions. Messages from the Assembly. Messages from the Governor. Reports of standing committees. Reports of select committees, communications and reports from state officers, motions and resolutions. Senator Klein.
Madam President, I have several motions. First, on behalf of Senator Thompson, I move to recommit Senate print number 2766, calendar number 34, on order of third reading to the Committee on Finance.
So ordered.
On behalf of Senator Oppenheimer, I move to recommit Senate print number 3315, calendar number 44, on the order of third reading to the Committee on Local Governments.
So ordered.
On behalf of Senator Schneiderman, I move that the following bill be discharged from its respective committee and be recommitted with instructions to strike the enacting clause, Senate number 1633.
So ordered.
On behalf of Senator Montgomery, I move the following bill be discharged from its respective committee and be recommitted with instructions to strike the enacting clause, Senate number 1293A.
So ordered. Senator Klein.
Madam President, are there any substitutions at the desk?
Yes, there are. Secretary will read.
On page 9, Senator Sampson moves to discharge from the Committee on Codes Assembly Bill number 7395 and substitute it for the identical Senate Bill number 4534, third reading calendar 132. On page 12, Senator DeLon moves to discharge from the Committee on Codes Assembly Bill number 225A and substitute it for the identical Senate Bill number 1169B, third reading calendar 187. On page 12, Senator Schneiderman moves to discharge from the Committee on Codes Assembly Bill number 5537A and substitute it for the identical Senate Bill number 4593A, third reading calendar 188. On page 12, Senator DeLon moves to discharge from the Committee on Codes Assembly Bill number 4467A and substitute it for the identical Senate Bill number 5172A, third reading calendar 190. On page 13, Senator Huntley moves to discharge from the Committee on Codes Assembly Bill number 9534 and substitute it for the identical Senate Bill number 6728, third reading calendar 192. On page 13, Senator Valesky moves to discharge from the Committee on Local Government Assembly Bill number 901A and substitute it for the identical Senate Bill number 2831A, third reading calendar 198. And on page 14, Senator Stavisky moves to discharge from the Committee on Finance Assembly Bill number 8220 and substitute it for the identical Senate Bill number 4199, third reading calendar 201.
Substitutions ordered. Senator Klein.
Madam President, I believe Senator Sampson has a resolution at the desk. I ask that the title of the resolution be read and move for its immediate adoption.
Senator Klein, has this resolution been deemed privileged and submitted by the Office of the Temporary President?
Yes, it has, Madam President.
Thank you. The Secretary will read.
By Senators Sampson, Squadron, Stavisky, and Duane, legislative resolution commending Asian Americans for equality upon the occasion of its 36th annual Lunar New Year banquet on March 11, 2010.
The question is on the resolution. All those in favor of adopting the resolution signify by saying aye. Opposed, nay. The resolution is adopted. Senator Klein.
Motion at the desk. I ask that the title of the resolution be read and move for its immediate adoption.
Senator Klein, has this resolution been deemed privileged and submitted by the Office of the Temporary President?
Yes, it has, Madam President.
The Secretary will read.
By Senator Volker, legislative resolution commending Niall Burgess, Consul General of Ireland at New York, upon the occasion of his designation for special recognition by the New York State American Irish Legislators Society at its annual dinner.
Senator Volker.
I would just like to remind everybody that tonight is the annual Irish American dinner at the Hibernian Hall. And we hope to have the usual Irish ruckus there. And this resolution I'm going to present to Niall Burgess, who's the Consul General of Ireland, at the dinner. And I appreciate the passage of this resolution on this date. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Volker. Are there any senators wishing to be heard on the resolution? And the question is on the resolution. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye. Opposed, nay. The resolution is adopted. Senator Volker has indicated that he'd like to open this resolution up to the entire body for co-sponsorship. Any senator wishing to not be on the resolution, please inform the desk. Senator Klein.
President, at this time, can we please move to a reading of the calendar?
The Secretary will read.
Calendar number 61 by member of the Assembly, Grabiznik. Assembly Bill number 9925, an act to amend the civil service law in relation to resolution.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, Espada, Kruger, Skelos, Smith, Young. Ayes, 56.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 174 by Senator Squadron. Senate Print 5577A, an act to amend the Alcoholic Beverage Control Law in relation to making provisions.
Read the last section.
Section 5, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, Espada, Kruger, Skelos, Smith, Young.
Announce the results.
Ayes, 56.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 176 by Senator Klein. Senate Print 5726, an act to amend the Not-for-Profit Corporation Law in relation to reacquisition.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, Espada, Kruger, Skelos, Smith, Young.
Announce the results.
Those recorded in the negative on calendar number 176 are Senators Larkin and Marcelino. In relation to calendar number 176, Senator Larkin recorded in the affirmative. Senator Marcelino recorded in the negative. Ayes 56, nays 1.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 176 by Senator L. Kruger, Senate Print 4260A, an act to amend the real property tax law.
Read the last section.
All right. Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, Espada, Kruger, Skelos, Smith, Young.
This is the vote on calendar number 178. Senator Salant to explain his vote.
Thank you, Madam President. Explain my vote. Madam President, I'm voting against this bill not because it adds or specifies a designee from New York City to be on this particular real property services board, but by inference, it elevates one geographic area of the state over a host of other geographic areas or regions of the state, and this particular region of the state, while it experiences real property issues, as does all others, it historically has had a maintenance of effort that's lower than any other region of the state. So I don't know why we're picking just the city of New York when there are a host of other regions that would be crying out for the same type of membership. And I'm going to, as I mentioned when I rose, vote in the negative. Thank you, Madam President.
Senator Salant to be recorded in the negative. Senator DeFrancisco.
Yes, this bill is extremely ironic. Being from central New York, we have a government now with a governor from New York City, a lieutenant governor from New York City, non-elected, by the way, lieutenant governor from New York City. We got an attorney general from New York City. We got an assembly overwhelmingly controlled by New York City. We've got a Senate majority, 23 out of the 32 majority from New York City. We've got, we're still waiting, by the way, for our road and bridge money after the MTA bailout. We also have chairman of finance from New York City, vice chairman of finance for New York City. And I could go on to each of the various positions in the state Senate. And it seems to me that if anybody needs protection, it's those regions outside of New York City in view of the New York City-centric government that we currently have at the present time. So I vote no.
Senator DeFrancisco to be recorded in the negative. Are there any other senators wishing to explain his or her vote? Hearing none, announce the results.
Those recorded in the negative on calendar number 178 are senators Alisi, Bonasek, DeFrancisco, Farley, Griffo, Hannon, Larkin, Laval, Libel, Little, Marcelino, Ranzenhofer, Robach, Saland, Skelos, Winner, and Young. Also, Senator Flanagan. Ayes 39, nays 18.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 185 by Senator Duane.
The bill is laid aside for the day.
Calendar number 192, substituted earlier by Member of the Assembly Gordon. Assembly print number 9534, an act to amend the penal law in relation to endangering the welfare.
Read the last section.
Section 4, this act shall take effect on the 60th day.
Call the roll.
Adams, Espada, Kruger, Skello, Smith, Young.
Announce the results.
Ayes 57.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 197 by Senator Aubertine. Senate print 2813B, an act to amend the public authorities law and the executive law in relation to establishing.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, Espada, Kruger, Skello, Smith, Young.
Announce the results.
Those recorded in the negative on calendar number 197 are Senators Golden, Marcelino, and Ranzenhofer. Ayes 54, nays 3.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 200 by Senator Oppenheimer. Senate print 3903A, an act to amend the education law in relation to cooperative competitive bidding.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, Espada, Kruger, Skello, Smith, Young.
Announce.
Ayes 57.
Senator DeFrancisco to explain his vote.
Yes, I'm voting in the affirmative. This is an excellent bill, especially in view of the fact that libraries are completely hammered by the governor's proposed budget. And it's important to be able to do things much more efficiently and by cooperative bidding that will help. And speaking of the budget, we're well past 10 days from the date that the governor submitted the budget to the legislature. And we're rapidly approaching April 1. And the law that we passed to reform the system, I know we have a lot of reformers in this room, that law says that we're supposed to have conference committees appointed, not only, and a schedule of open conference, joint conference committees by the Assembly and the Senate. We are now approaching, I think it's almost 2.5 weeks to the budget, 3 weeks, when we're supposed to have the budget in. So I would request that in addition to passing wonderful bills like this one that I voted in the affirmative, it might be a good idea to follow the law that we already have and the reformers that we have in this room who sued before reform, who campaigned on reform, who got a majority based upon reform, who speak reform on a daily basis. Follow the rules as they exist, because that was reform. And that would help us start the budget process. And it doesn't help just to blame the governor for his failures or his being distracted. The fact of the matter is the governor proposed the budget, proposed 21-day amendments. It's up to the legislature to do their job. So we're waiting, and we're waiting not so patiently. Thank you, Madam President.
Thank you, Senator DeFrancisco, who was recorded in the affirmative, and the bill has passed. Secretary.
Calendar number 202 by Senator C. Krueger.
Bill is laid aside for the day.
Calendar number 204 by Senator Aubertine. Senate print 4837, an act to amend the highway law in relation to permitting.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, Espada, Krueger, Skelos, Smith, Young.
Senator Montgomery to explain her vote.
Yes, Madam President. I rise in favor of this legislation, and I thank Senator Aubertine for introducing it. It certainly is revenue neutral as it relates to the state, because it simply authorizes farmers to advertise their goods on state highways. And I think this is an absolutely wonderful idea, and I'm happy that we are paying attention in small as well as large ways to what happens to farmers upstate. And I take this opportunity to thank the farmers, the many, many farmers who every weekend, even beginning now and on through the summer and through the spring and into the fall, who come down to New York City and bring fresh produce to people in my district and all over the city. We welcome them, we thank them, because for many communities that I represent, they really are the only source of fresh produce. And so it's the farmers in New York State serving the citizens of New York State in urban areas like mine, where we don't have our own farms, maybe one or two small ones, but they really make the difference for us. And so we thank them, and certainly I'm happy to support them being able to advertise on the highways in our state. Thank you, Madam President. I vote aye.
Senator Montgomery to be recorded in the affirmative. Are there any other senators wishing to explain his or her vote? Announce the results.
Ayes 57, nays 0.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 205 by Senator Farley, Senate print 5182A, an act to amend the alcoholic beverage control law in relation to exemption.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, Espada, Krueger, Skelos, Smith, Young. Ayes 57.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 207, Senate budget bill. Senate print 6602, an act making appropriations for the legal requirements of the state debt service.
The bill is laid aside.
Calendar number 211 by Senator Addabbo. Senate print.
The bill is laid aside for the day. Senator Klein, that completes the reading of the non-controversial calendar.
Madam President, can we please go to a reading of the controversial calendar?
Secretary will ring the bell. Members are all asked to come to the chamber for the controversial reading of the calendar. Secretary will read.
Thank you. Calendar number 207, Senate Budget Bill, Senate Print 6602, an act making appropriations for the legal requirements.
Senator Flanagan.
Madam President, can we get an explanation of the bill?
Senator Krueger, an explanation has been requested.
Thank you. Through you, Madam President. The bill is a simple one. It provides for the mandatory payment of our debt service for the fiscal year.
Madam President, would Senator Krueger yield to several questions?
Senator Krueger, do you yield?
Well, let's take them one at a time.
Would Senator Krueger yield to a question?
Senator Krueger, do you yield to a question?
Yes, I do.
Senator Krueger yields.
Senator Krueger, what's the total amount of debt service authorized in this bill?
$5.86 billion.
My understanding, through you, Madam President, would
Senator Krueger, do you
continue
to yield?
Yes, I do.
My understanding in reviewing this with our own staff is that the total appropriation authority is for $9.29 billion.
That's correct.
Madam President, through you, would Senator Krueger continue to yield?
Senator Krueger, do you continue to yield?
Okay. I realize this is esoteric, it's technical, it's not the most exciting thing in the world, but I'm trying to figure out how can I go back when people are going to ask potential questions about this and properly explain the details, because in reality what we're doing as part of this exercise today is starting the budget process, certainly in the form of passing bills. So my initial two questions now give me a contradictory set of facts. On the one hand, you said it authorizes $5.86 billion, and then I asked you if it was really $9.29 billion. And you said, yes, it was. So What is the answer? Is it $9.29 billion or $5.86
billion? $5.86 billion cash.
Okay. And, Madam President, for you, would Senator Krueger continue to yield?
Senator Krueger.
Yes, I do.
Senator Krueger continues to yield.
Senator Krueger, what makes up that difference? If it's $5.86 billion in cash, what's the rest of it? Because that's not a small amount of money.
No, it's a large amount of money, actually. It's tinged upon several factors. Firstly, we're also looking, when you're talking about that $9.2 billion, we're also talking about a... let's go simple. I'll try to keep it for myself. The $5.86 billion is an increase, when we start going to the $9.2 billion, an increase $718 million, which would be based upon the budget as proposed, which would be actual, that would be the appropriation. So that's number one. The total expenditures for the state debt service are projected at $6.4 billion, for the 2010-2011, which would be an increase of $8.12 million, which is a 14.3% increase.
Madam President, through you, would Senator Krueger continue to yield?
Senator Krueger, do you continue to yield?
Yes, I do.
I believe you said $5.86 billion and then an additional, was it $800 million or $600
million? $718 million.
Comprising what?
It's an increase year over year.
I'm not worried about the increase year over year. I'm worried about what authority are we giving to DOB and to the executive to play with that other money, the roughly $3.5 billion. What makes up that $3.5 billion?
Well, the contingent appropriation would be $2.766 billion.
Okay, and what is
Senator
that,
Flanagan.
Madam President, through you.
Senator Krueger, do you continue to yield?
Yes, I do.
What is that money supposed to be for? Because that, again, if we're talking in the context of the budget, we're talking about a substantial amount of new debt or debt service being available to the division of the budget.
Just to clarify that point, Senator, through you, Madam President, there is no new debt in this bill. This is to pay our obligations of prior debt.
Madam President, would Senator Krueger continue to yield?
Yes,
Senator
I do.
Krueger.
Senator Krueger, it's my understanding that there is money in here to provide for new debt service for capital projects that will be issued in fiscal year 2010 and 2011. Is that accurate or not?
There are no new capital programs.
Madam President, for you, would Senator Krueger continue to yield?
Senator
yes,
Krueger,
I do.
Do you continue to yield?
I appreciate the answer. That was not my question. My question is, are we providing new authority to pay debt service for capital projects that may come into existence in the next budget? I know there are no new capital programs right now, but would there possibly be under this legislation?
For you, Madam President, no.
Madam President, through you, would Senator Krueger continue to yield?
Senator Krueger, do you continue to yield?
Yes, I do.
Senator Krueger, I have in front of me a list of new sales from five different authorities and agencies that are projected for fiscal year 2010-2011, approximately $4.5 billion in new debt, which would call for $155 million in new debt service that would be part of this bill that we're doing today. I didn't make this bill. The governor made this bill, and you're presenting it to us. So how does that fly with what you're telling me? Because I'm going on information that was provided by the Division of the Budget and the executive. It clearly says that we are giving them authority for the issuance of new debt.
What, through you, Madam President, I guess in terms that we can understand, there is no new debt. This is debt to pay for existing programs as they move forward.
Okay. One last question for Senator Krueger, if he would.
Senator Krueger, do
My
you
pleasure.
Yield?
My pleasure. Thank you.
I want to be clear. I do not for one second, I don't think any of us want to be an agent of delay, but it is March 8th. and our fiscal year ends March 31st. Why are we doing this bill today when we haven't even started any other part of the budget?
Well, through you, Madam President, I guess we could say that we're sending, as this, my ranker on finance wanted to point out, you said this is the first budget bill. We want to send a very clear and compelling message to the bankers and to the bond markets and all the other folks out there that want to listen, that we're in the process of developing a budget. This is not new debt. This is debt that we're obligated to pay, and under authority, we will pay it.
Madam President, on the bill. Thank you, Senator.
Thank you.
Senator Flanagan, on the bill.
I just want to offer some general comments in relation to the process that we are purportedly starting today, otherwise known as the New York State budget. When I was asking Senator Krueger questions, I want to, again, be very, very clear. I understand, we all understand, we have debts, we have obligations, we need to meet those, we need to pay them on time, and I think we absolutely should be doing that. In conjunction with that, though, I think we have to take a fresh, new, hard look at every single thing that we do. My reading of this bill is that there is $5.86 billion that needs to be paid now. Now, cold, hard cash that needs to go out the door. That was our credit card. That's our minimum payment. That's what we need to do. We also have a $250 million dry appropriation from the Debt Reduction Reserve Fund that may be available to help defease bonds. I think that's a good thing, and that could be very helpful. But I also believe that we're providing a tremendous amount of latitude and authority to the tune of almost another $3 billion, for which I don't feel there's enough justification. Now, I know that people are going to say that's what the past practices are. We can't run the risk of doing this or sending the wrong signal to the markets. I think we can actually do both. What we should be doing right now is carving this bill out a little bit or whittling it down to say, tell us exactly what you need. Whatever it is you have to pay, we'll come up with the money and we'll pay it. And frankly, ladies and gentlemen, it's less than what this bill is calling for and asking for. And if we get in a situation where the executive or the division of budget has to come back and say, you know what, there have been some changes. Rates have gone up. We have to do things a little differently. We want to do some swaps that may affect our debt service. That's okay. That's okay. But I think we're missing the boat here by doing this in the way that we've done it in the past. Did I support the debt service bill last year and vote against the budget? Yes, I did. I know we need to pay our obligations. But to follow up on the comments of my colleague, Senator DeFrancisco, I think it's also important to recognize that while we are taking this perhaps baby step forward, there are a litany of things that are left unanswered. I raised a point that I believe is 100% accurate, that we are providing the possibility for new debt, for capital that will, capital programs that will come into being in this prospective budget, and that there will be debt service associated with that to the tune of $155 million or thereabouts. I'd like to know what the programs are. I'd like to know what the distribution is. I think we should all like to know that, and we should want to know that. But part of the problem is we're not doing anything else. Here we are. It's now March 8th, and we have not followed the law. The majority in this House, the Senate Democrats, have not followed the law. There are well-known parameters in the Budget Reform Act of 2007 that are clear, concise, simple, and easy to follow. What's lacking is the political will to do it. Why don't we have conference committees? Forget the conference committees. Why don't we even have a schedule? Why don't we even have members named to the conference committees? We can't even name our members because we don't even know what the committees are. The public at this juncture, they may not expect to have all the nuances and all the details of the budget laid out, but they sure as heck think that we should be following a law that we all supported and enacted a couple of years ago. This sends maybe a decent signal to the markets, but it sure as heck sends a terrible message to the taxpayers. I care about what the bond market thinks, but ladies and gentlemen, I care a heck of a lot more about what the taxpayer and the property taxpayer thinks, and if we start off like this, then we're going down the same bad path that we started to last year. I understand that we have obligations. I'm going to vote no on this bill because I think we should be making changes to keep DOB's feet and the executive's feet much closer to the fire. Thank you.
Senator Marcellino.
Thank you, Madam President. Let me add my voice to my colleague, Senator Flanagan's voice on the bill.
Senator Mussolino on the bill.
There's money. Yes, we have to take our first steps at the budget, and this is the beginning of it. This seems to be the beginning. There are other things, as Senator Flanagan has said, and I won't go through it all again to add to our time, that should be done by now. The law is clear. We're simply not following it, but we should, in my mind. I look at this bill as a checkbook. You put money in the checkbook to pay your bills. We should be paying the bills that we owe. If we owe money, we should pay it. And there should be money in the book to pay for the bills we owe. You put more money in your checkbook than you need, you're going to spend that money. It's that simple. I understand that we may need a cushion, that there may be some adjustable rate situations that might come forward and might come up later on in the year. But as Senator Flanagan rightly pointed out, then let them come back to the chamber, if need be, and say, look, this happened, this changed, conditions were altered, we need more money at this point in time, give us the authorization, here are the bills, here's the amount of money we need, here are the projects we have to pay for, this is why they're important, let us go forward. So we go forward, but we do so in an informed way. I think I'm just getting to the point, and I think my constituents are getting to the point where we're tired of these so-called dry appropriations. Put money out there. Yes, we've done it in the past. It was wrong. It's led us in the wrong position. It's put us in the wrong place right now. We can't afford to do that anymore. We have to change our methods. We have to change our procedures. And we should. I'd be willing to work with you on that. Let's change the process now. Let's not continue to do the same old, and ending up with the same old bad results. That's more debt. We don't need more debt anymore. We need less. We don't need more spending. We need less. And we need a process that will get us to the point where the public will begin to respect this legislature. The governor, for good or ill, with all his distractions, presented us with a budget, and he presented it early. He gave us his 21-day amendments. Do I agree with everything in them? Absolutely not. Do I agree with everything in the governor's budget? Absolutely not. If you put that on the table, I'd vote no. Right today, here and now. However, we should be going through a process now to reconcile those issues. Where's the assembly's budget? Let's get that out here. Let's get our budget out on the table. Let's move forward together in a bipartisan way. That word is used a lot, but it's not acted on. We say it, but we don't do it. We talk it, but there's no action. Let's get some action here. Again, I will not. I didn't support this bill last year and last year's budget, and I was right. Last year's budget was out of whack even with this. And the way we're going right now, we're going to have another budget that's out of whack because we're doing it quietly. We're doing it behind the scenes, and we're doing it out of ignorance. We don't know. Nobody here knows what's in the proposed budget. Nobody. The other side, our side, nobody knows what's in a proposed budget because we don't have one. And there's no process that I can see moving forward that's going to bring us together so we can come together with a real budget to show the people of this state that this is not a dysfunctional house, that this is not a dysfunctional legislature, and that we deserve to be where we are. I just attended a meeting of the Council of State Governments over the weekend. We are the laughing stock of the nation. When everybody has a problem, they say, well, you don't want to be like New York. Well, you don't want to be like California. We're getting laughed at, and I don't like that. I don't enjoy that. It's not fun. And I know you're not enjoying it either. Anybody, everybody around here, we all feel it. We're all getting it. But we're doing the same things that are going to lead us down the same path to another budget that isn't balanced, to another budget that won't work, to another summer where we're going to be called back to fix it. This is not the year you want to come back in the summertime to fix a budget. We will have other things to be doing at that point in time. So, ladies and gentlemen, I suggest this bill be pulled, this bill be pared down, this bill be put, as Senator Flanagan rightly said, to what we absolutely need to pay so that we can meet our obligations and we can send the right message to the bonding institutions that this state is operating on a fiscally prudent method in a fiscally prudent way. We will pay our bills. Well, we're not going to put that slush fund out there so that maybe, in case, possibly, on some unknown issue, something happens, and then we're out there, and the taxpayers are going to foot the bill down the road. Madam President, I'm going to be voting no when this bill comes up. I would prefer to vote yes, but I would prefer to vote yes on a bill that is to the point and to the dollar that we need, not on some mythical number. Thank you, Madam President.
Thank you, Senator. Are there any other senators wishing to be heard on the bill? Hearing none, debate is closed. Secretary will please ring the bell. Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, Espada, Krueger, Skello, Smith, Young.
Announce the results.
For those recorded in the negative on calendar number 207 are Senators Alisi, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Griffo, Hannon, O. Johnson, Larkin, Laval, Libous, Marcelino, Maziarz, Nozzolio, Ranzenhofer, Robach, Winner, and Young. Absent from voting, Senator Volker. Ayes 42, nays 16.
The bill is passed. Senator Klein, that completes the reading of the controversial calendar.
Madam President, on behalf of Senator Smith, I hand up the following leadership notice and ask that it be filed in the journal.
To be filed in the journal. Senator Klein.
Can you please recognize Senator Ruth Hassel Thompson for an announcement?
Senator Hassel Thompson.
Thank you. Madam President, at 6:30 there is a meeting of the majority conference.
At 6:30 there will be a meeting of the majority conference. Senator Klein.
Madam President, is there any further business at the desk?
Senator Klein, the desk is clear.
There being none, Madam President, I move that we adjourn until Tuesday, March 9th at 3 p.m.
There being no further business to come before the Senate, on motion, the Senate stands adjourned until Tuesday, March 9th at 3 p.m.